Welcome back to my lectures of class 11 physics. We are studying the chapter motion in a straight line. And in the previous video, we have seen the derivation of equations of motion using analytical method. Now we have the same derivations of the three equations of motion but using graphical methods. And before going on that method, let us see the conclusions based on VT graph. First of all, we will derive the conclusion and then we will use those conclusions to derive the equation of motion using graphical methods. Okay, so here if we have this VT graph, here we have time on the x-axis and we have velocity on the y-axis. Okay, here you can see it's a uniform motion where the starting point is not from the origin but from some other point. Okay, so the first conclusion that we can draw from this is that from this graph we can directly calculate the acceleration by calculating its slope. Now what is the slope? That slope is simply the tan theta. Tan theta, that is equals to, I can write perpendicular upon base. Here perpendicular, that is equals to, in this triangle, V2 minus V1 and the base, that is the time, that is T2 minus T1. Matlab yahan par kya hai? Tan theta is equals to, this is dV by dt. Matlab yahan par kitna ho jayega? This tan theta is directly equals to acceleration a, because acceleration is equals to dv by dt. मतलब यहाँ पर क्या हो जाएगा, जो स्लोप tan theta के इक्वल होता है वो किसके इक्वल हो जाएगा, that is equals to the acceleration. So directly by calculating the slope of the curve we can find the acceleration. This is the first conclusion. Now the second conclusion, that is we can also find the distance covered by that body from this graph. How we can calculate? We can simply calculate the area under the curve. अगर हम area under the curve calculate कर लें, तो हम वहाँ पर क्या calculate कर लेंगे? We can easily find the distance covered by that body. Okay, so let us see here. This V1 is the starting point, or we can say this is the velocity at point A, and V2 is the velocity at point C. Similarly, at point A the time is T1, and at point E the time is T2. So we have this formula that average velocity is equals to displacement upon time. Now here if you want to calculate the displacement, in the case of straight line motion, distance and displacement, they both are same. So if I want to calculate the displacement, then that is equals to average velocity into time. Now here average velocity, here the acceleration is constant because we have same slope. So for the same slope, acceleration will be constant. And for the constant acceleration, I can write this average velocity as V1 plus V2 by 2. This we have seen while deriving the equations of motion using analytical methods. Into time, this time is equals to T2 minus T1. Okay, now this V1 is same as AB. This velocity from 0 to V1, I can write it as AB. So this is AB. Plus V2, with this V2 velocity I can write from C to D, that is CD divided by 2. And this T2 minus T1, I can write BD. Okay, now here you can see this formula, half sum of the parallel sides, these two sides AB and CD, they both are parallel. So AB plus CD, that is half sum of parallel sides into distance between them. So kya ho gaya? Half into sum of parallel sides into distance between them. So what it is? It is the area of trapezium. Ab yahan par trapezium kaun sa hai? ACDB. That is ACDB. Aur humne ye jo parameters liye the, ye kahan tak liye the? From A to C. Matlab hume yahan par jo distance calculate karni hai from A to C, then we have to calculate the area under that curve AC, will get the distance travel. So these are the two important conclusions that we will use while deriving the equations of motion using graphical method. So now after looking at the conclusions based on the graph, we will derive the equations of motion using graphical method. So for that, let us draw a graph, that is VT graph. Here it is time and here it is velocity. Okay, now here we will draw a curve. This is again a straight line curve, or we can say it represents a uniform motion. This represents O point, this is A, and we'll assume some another point, that is point B. At point A, the velocity I am considering it is V1, and at point B, the velocity, that is equals to V2, and here at point B, the time I am considering is t. Okay, and here let me draw this line. Okay, so by this graph we will derive the equations of motion. Now the first equation of motion, what is the first equation of motion? That is equals to v is equals to u plus at. It is also called as velocity time relation. Okay, now the first conclusion that we have drawn from the graph, that we can calculate the acceleration directly from the slope. So in this graph, the slope, that is simply equals to tan theta, and that will give you the value of acceleration a. So a is equals to the slope. Slope here, I can write this angle as theta. Slope is this perpendicular upon base. If I give this name as d, then it is bd, that is perpendicular upon base ad. Okay, so this acceleration a is equals to bd. I can write this bd as v2 minus v1. So it is equals to v2 minus v1 divided by ad. This ad as same as time t. This is t. So here this v2 minus v1 is equals to at, or I can write v2 is equals to v1 plus at. Now what this v2 is? This v2 is final velocity, and this final velocity is represented by v and v1. This v1 is the initial velocity and it is represented by u. So while putting these values, I can get v is equals to u plus at. So this is the first equation of motion that we can derive graphically. So after looking at the first equation of motion, let us see the second equation of motion, that is s is equals to ut plus half at square. And this equation is also called as position time relation. Okay, now here we have to derive this equation by using graphical methods. Now here we will use the second conclusion we have drawn from that graph, that if you want to calculate the distance traveled, then we can calculate it by calculating the area under the curve. So here we have the two different areas. So if we will add these two areas, we will get the distance traveled between A and B. And that is what we have to find in this second equation. So here this distance traveled is equals to the area of triangle. Here this triangle is ABD. ABD plus area of this rectangle AD, let us give its name as C. So area of rectangle ADCO. So if we will write both the areas, then we will get the total distance traveled. So this distance traveled, I can simply write it as S. Okay, then area of triangle ABD, that is equals to half into base. Base is equals to AD into height BD plus area, this AO into this AD. Okay, so after this we have this acceleration, that is directly equals to the slope, and that slope is equals to perpendicular upon base. So I can write this acceleration is equals to BD upon AD. Okay, so here I can write this BD is equals to A into AD. Okay, and this AD, this AD is same as the time from 0 to T. So I can write this BD is equals to A into T. Okay, now here this S is equals to half. What is the value of AD? AD is equals to time T, and BD, this BD equals to AT plus AO. This AO is equals to initial velocity, that is V1, into this AD. This AD is again the time T, and this V1, that is the initial velocity. So I can write this V1 as U. So S is equals to half, it becomes AT square plus U into T. So we have S equals to UT plus half AT square. So in this way we can derive the second equation of motion graphically by using the conclusion which we have drawn from the velocity time graph. So after looking at the second equation of motion, let us see the third equation of motion, that is v square minus u square is equals to 2as, and this is also called as position velocity relation because it relates the position and velocity. Now here we have this position, so we have to find the position also here. So here again we will use the second conclusion, that is the distance traveled is equals to area under the curve. Means if we have to find the displacement from A to B, then we have to find the area under the curve. इससे पहले वाले हमने क्या देखा, हमने यहाँ पर ट्राइंगल और रेक्टेंगल का एरिया ऐड कर दिया था. बट हियर इन दिस केस टू फाइंड द डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल्ड विल फाइंड द कंप्लीट एरिया एंड दिस इज अ ट्रेपेजियम. सो वी विल यूज द फॉर्मूला फॉर ट्रेपेजियम. सो एस इक्वल्स टू एरिया ऑफ ट्रेपेजियम. दिस ट्रेपेजियम इज ए बी डी सी ओ. सो एरिया ऑफ ट्रेपेजियम दैट इज इक्वल्स टू हाफ इंटू सम ऑफ पैरेलल sides into distance between them. So this is the formula to calculate the area of a trapezium. Now some of the parallel sides, the parallel sides we have AO and BC. So here I can write some of parallel sides, that is AO, this is AO plus BC plus BC into distance between them. Distance between them is AD. Okay, now here we have to replace this AD. This AD we have to replace. How we can replace? We know that how we have calculated the acceleration. A is equals to the slope, and that slope is equals to perpendicular upon base, and that is equals to BD by AD. So from here I can write this AD is equals to BD by A. तो यहां पर जो AD की वैल्यू उसको हम क्या कर देंगे, BD by A. So I can write this S is equals to half AO plus BC into this AD is equals to BD by A. Now we'll put the values. S is equals to half. What is this AO? This AO is same as V1 initial velocity plus this BC, that is the final velocity V2, into this BD. What this BD is? This BD is same as V2 minus V1. अगर इस V2 में से V1 को माइनस कर देंगे, we will get this BD. So I can write this BD as V2 minus V1 by A. Okay, so here S is equal to this V1 is the initial velocity and we are representing it by U, plus V2 that is the final velocity and we are representing it by V into again V2 final velocity is V, initial velocity is U by A. Okay, now here we have formula A plus B and A minus B. So A plus B, A minus B, that is equals to A square minus B square. So I can write it as V square minus U square by 2A is equals to S. So I can write 2AS is equals to V square minus U square. Or we can also write V square minus U square is equals to 2AS. This is the third equation of motion, that is position velocity relation. So in this way we can derive the three equations of motion using the graphical method also by considering the conclusions which we have drawn from the velocity time graph.